Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. This is a series of videos about SolidWorks scripting using Python. And in this video, we are going to talk about how to add dimension and how to edit it. Let me first explain why adding a dimension is very important. In two previous videos, we talked about how to create a sketch. For example, I'm going to create a line here. And we learned how to create this line using code using Python in, for example, Visual Studio. But sometimes you need to edit this sketch. For example, you created a line here and you need to change its length. In SolidWorks, we can do this. For example, this line, and here I can change its length, for example, to 50 millimeters. And now you can see I am able to change its length. Let me use macro here. I'm starting a macro. I'm selecting a line and I'm going to change its length to 100 and enter. Okay. Let me save this macro and open it. As you can see here, the macro couldn't record any of my action to change the line length. And there is another way to understand this. Let me go to API help. The function we used to create a line was create a line method under sketch manager. And we talk about return value. So we are going to see return value and under members. As we talk about, there are two different groups. One of them is public methods and other one is public properties. In public methods, we are not able, In public methods, we are not able to change anything because all of them is gets, not set. And for example, for the length, we can just get the length and we are not able to set the length. But in the public properties, we are able to set. And as you can see, we don't have any length or set length in public properties. So we are not able to change the length of a line or even circle or other sketch in SolidWorks using code directly. But there is another way. Let me talk about it. In this method, we are going to use a smart dimension or add dimension here. And we are going to talk about how to use this function to add a length to or add a dimension to our sketch. And now we are able to change it to whatever number we want. For example, 50 millimeters for this line. Okay, let's talk about adding a dimension to our sketch. Okay, I'm going to start a macro to show you how to add a dimension to a sketch. I'm going to select add dimension or export dimension, select my sketch or line here in this case, and create a dimension. Okay. Save my macro and open it. As you can see here, first the macro is going to select my line. Then it will going to use part.addDimension2. Let's try this. This line of code, part.addDimension. I'm going to copy it and paste it in SolidWorks. First, let me to line my libraries and connect Python to SolidWorks. Okay, I'm going to delete this dimension and let me rearrange my windows. I'm going to select this line first manually and run this block of code. As you can see here, the SolidWorks trying to create a dimension for me, but this box is pop up and prevent to finish the work. So I need to manually accept this dimension. And as you can see, after 19 minutes, SolidWorks can finish this job because I need to select or accept the dimension manually. But we don't like that because we need to do whatever we want with code. So let me show you something. In setting, let me maximize. In setting, system options under general, we have something called input dimension value. If I uncheck this and press OK. I think I'm able now to create a dimension just with code. Let me select my line and run this block of code another time. And as you can see, now I'm able to create a dimension just with code. But how to uncheck and check this box with code? Let me explain that. We have something in SolidWorks called swapApp.setUserPreferenceToggle. I think it should be lowercase. And here I'm going to use 10 for the first argument and false for the second argument. If I pass false in the setting, this box will be unchecked. And if I pass true, this box will be checked. So let me check it first. Okay. And now I'm going to run this block of code and we expect that bug become unchecked. Okay. I'm going to run this block of code and let me open this setting. As you can see, now I'm able to check or uncheck this box manually. Let me reset to default. And we are going to combine add dimension with this new function to be able to create a dimension fully with code. First, I'm going to copy this code and paste it here. And I'm going to pass false because first I like to uncheck the box. Then I'm going to create a dimension. Then I'm going to check the box because I like the setting be as default as I had them. Okay, I'm going to pass true. And let me rearrange my windows another time. Okay, I'm going to select this line and run this block of code. And as you can see, now I'm able to create a dimension fully with code. Okay, let's talk about add dimension 2. API help, add dimension 2 under model doc 2. We can see here, add dimension 2 gets three different arguments, x, y, and z. And they are just text location in meters. So they are not very important argument and they will be specified the location of this text or this dimension. So you can choose when whatever number you want, but it's better to use the number that are close to the location of the sketch you are choosing. Okay, let's create some dimension for some sketches. First, I'm going to create a circle here and I like to create a dimension for it. Before, I like to select this circle and I'm going to use select by ID, but I prefer to use macro because it's much more easier. As you can see, I'm able to select this sketch using this part of code. So I'm going to copy it and paste it in Visual Studio. I'm going to paste it here and I'm going to use Python com.nothing. Then I'm going to use add dimension. Okay, I'm going to copy this and paste it here. And for the location, I think, for example, this point is okay. And it will be, let me show you. And this point will be okay. And the location will be 52 for X, 81 for Y. So I'm going to pass this here, 0.05 millimeters or meters here. And 0.08 for Y, okay? And I need to disable and then enable that box. First, I'm going to disable it and then I'm going to enable it. So let me fix that. Okay. Now I think I'm able to create a dimension for this circle when I run this code. Let me run it. And as you can see, I'm able to create a dimension for this circle. If I want to explain it, first I'm going to select this arc or circle. Then I'm going to uncheck the box that bring up the box dimension for me. Then I'm going to create a dimension, as you can see here. Then I'm going to check the box again. Let's test it in another sketch. I'm going to create a simple slot here. Okay, I'm going to use macro. I'm going to start recording my action. Select a smart dimension. Select this point and then this point. Then I'm going to create a dimension here and stop the macro. Save it, then open it. I'm going to copy all of these codes and paste them in Visual Studio. Then I'm going to edit them. In the first and the second line, it will select the point, first point and second point, I mean. And I'm going to use Python com dot. I'm going to copy it and paste it here too. I'm going to delete this. And in the third code, it will create a dimension for me. We know that we should first uncheck the box, then enable it again. So I'm going to copy these codes from above and paste it here. Then I'm going to delete this dimension and run this block of code. As you can see, we are creating a dimension for a slot. So working with a smart dimension in Python or scripting it is very similar with using it manually in SolidWorks. For example, you need to click two points or just click one line. And they are very similar. So you are able to use it in Python and it is very easy to use. Vertical way. And then I have a dimension in the horizontal way. So for the line or sometimes other sketch, we have different options. So how we should choose between those? For example, you want to create a horizontal dimension. So in the options, we have something called horizontal dimension. I'm going to start a macro and horizontal dimension. I select this line, create a dimension for it. Okay. Then I'm going to save this macro here and then I'm going to open it. As you can see here, we have something new, a new function called add horizontal dimension to. So if you want to create a horizontal dimension, you can just use this function. I'm going to paste it here and delete set. And I just want to show you it works. So I'm going to delete this dimension and run this block of code. And as you can see, I'm able to create a dimension with horizontal dimension. And this box comes up because I didn't disable the set user preference target. But you are able to disable it. I just want to show you how it works. Okay. At last, we are going to talk about how to change this dimension. The purpose of this video was to how to change a length or a radius of a circle that we are not able to do it in SolidWorks directly using code, but we are able to do it using dimensions. So how to change a dimension? For example, now I have 98 millimeter and I like to put, for example, 120 millimeters here. Let's talk about first the return value of add dimension. I'm going to open it here. Add dimension, we have something called return value. In the return value for a line, we saw different properties and for add dimension, it has own return value. So I'm going to talk about it in members section. Sorry. In members section, we have a lot of methods and properties. Some of them are able to get or set, but some of them are just for get. I'm going to talk about get name first. I like to get the name of the dimension I just created. So I'm going to search it name and look for it here. With this method, I'm able to get the name of the dimension I just created. So I'm going to copy it and use it here. Okay, I'm going to paste it here, and this is an object. So I'm going to paste it here too, and dot. So with running this code, now I'm able to get the name of the dimension I just created. And for be sure, I'm going to click this, and you can see here the primary value. So this is the name of the dimension, and this is the name I got from the code. So how to change it? We need to do two things to be able to change a length or amount of a dimension. First, we are going to build a variable called my dimension, for example. You can use whatever you want. And part.parameter. And you need to pass the name of the dimension you like to change it. I'm going to pass this name here. Okay, I'm going to run it. It can run smoothly. And the last part is my dimension dot system value. And you now can specify the length you want. For example, I'm going to put, I don't know, 400 millimeters for this dimension. I'm going to run it. And as you can see, now I'm able to change the length of a sketch. Another time, I'm going to just first unselect it. Then I'm going to put 100. And you can see I'm able to change a length of any sketch I like. For example, if I have a circle here, I can change its radius very easily. So now you are able to create a sketch and then edit it. Okay guys, this was the end of this video. In summary, we talked about how to add a dimension. We talked about different options we have in a smart dimension, how to use them, and most important one, we talked about how to edit a dimension using Python and scripting it in the Visual Studio. See you guys in next videos, and goodbye.